click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see one of the application of op-amp that is nothing but sample and hold circuit. Now let's begin with the topic. Sample and hold circuit are basically used in the system where it is important to sample the value of input voltage and hold it for a certain period of time. But before going to understand the concept of sample and hold circuit by using op-amp, it is very much important to understand the basic concept behind sample and hold circuit. So let's first understand the basic of sample and hold circuit. In sample and hold circuit, there are two processes. First, sampling the input signal, and second, hold the sample value for a specific period of time. For that purpose, we need to consider basic sample and hold circuit, and the diagram is: the figure shows basic sample and hold circuit, which consists of one input, one output, one switch and one capacitor. The switch is controlled by using a control signal. The switch can be used either as a BJT or as a MOSFET. When they are properly biased, they can be used as a switch. So instead of normal switch, we can use BJT or MOSFET as a switch. The switches get controlled by a control voltage, and therefore the switch having two modes of operation, open switch and closed switch. Depending upon the position of switch, there are two modes of operation of basic sample and hold circuit. First is called as sampling mode and second is called as holding mode. In case of sampling mode, the switch is in the closed position. Therefore, the input voltage will appear across the capacitor. Because of this, the capacitor will charge to the instantaneous value of input voltage Vin. This process is called as sampling process. When the switch is get opened by using a control voltage, the capacitor is now disconnected from input voltage Vin, and therefore there is no path for the capacitor to get discharged. Because of this reason, the capacitor will now hold the value of voltage appears across it, and the holding time will be depend upon, and it will hold the value until the next sampling cycle. So this is how the charging and discharging of capacitor, that means the opening and closing of switch, will decide sampling and holding process. Now let's understand how the sample and hold circuit can be implemented by using op-amp. To understand the sample and hold circuit using op-amp, let's consider the circuit diagram first. Figure shows sample and hold circuit by using op-amp. Now in this figure, the diagram is divided into three parts. First is input buffer, second is basic sample and hold circuit, and third is output buffer. Now here, the basic sample and hold circuit consists of MOSFET and control voltage VC along with capacitor C. Here, the n-channel MOSFET is used as a switch, and the control voltage VC is applied to the gate terminal of MOSFET. Therefore, the control voltage VC is going to control the opening and closing of MOSFET. That means when the gate pulse is applied, the MOSFET is get turned on, and when the gate pulse is not applied, the MOSFET get turns off. And depending upon turning on and turning off of MOSFET, the capacitor get either charged or discharged. Now, let's understand the working of circuit. The circuit consists of three different parts. First is called as input buffer, which is nothing but voltage follower. The second part is basic sample and hold circuit. And the third part is again an output buffer, that is a voltage follower. The first input buffer A1 is used to avoid loading of input source, whereas the third output buffer, that means the A2, is used to avoid loading of capacitor C. Now when the control voltage VC is applied to the gate terminal of MOSFET, the MOSFET gate turns on. That means when VC is equals to 1, MOSFET gate on. Due to which the capacitor is get connected to the input buffer A1, and therefore the input voltage charges and capacitor will get charges to the instantaneous value of input voltage Vin. Now when VC is equals to 0, at that time the MOSFET gate turns off, and therefore capacitor C is now get disconnected from input buffer or from Vin. When VC is equals to 0, the MOSFET gate turns off, due to which the capacitor is get disconnected from input buffer or from Vin. The capacitor cannot discharge from output buffer or from op-amp A2. because the op amp having high input impedance. Therefore, the capacitor will now hold the charge until the next sampling cycle. So this is how the control voltage VC controls the opening and closing of switch. That means turning on or turning off of MOSFET, which charges the capacitor so that it can sample the input value, and turning off of MOSFET causes capacitor to get disconnected from input so that it can hold the value until the specific period of time. Now let's understand the waveform of sample and hold circuit. From the waveform of sample and hold circuit, we will come to know that the waveform is input waveform is sine wave. VS is nothing but command input signal, that is nothing but the control signal VC, which controls the turning off and turning off of MOSFET, and here is the output of waveform of sample and hold circuit. Now the waveform is divided into two time period, that means TS and TH. Therefore the total time period is nothing but T equals to TS plus TH, where TS is called as sampling time, whereas TH is called as holding time. So TS is defined as the time interval during which the capacitor will charge to the instantaneous value of input voltage and performs the sampling process is called as sampling time, whereas TH is called as holding time, and it is defined as the time interval during which the capacitor is get disconnected from input voltage and hold the charge present on it until the next sampling cycle, during which the holding process takes place, is called as holding time TH. So the time period total T is given by the combination of sampling time and the holding time. As the capacitor holds charge for a certain period of time, therefore the capacitor is required to be used as a leak proof capacitor. Therefore in most of the sample and hold circuit, Teflon capacitor or polyester capacitor are used in the circuit, so that they can avoid leaking of charge and the value of voltage can be held for a proper period of time. Now there are certain applications of sample and hold circuit. Now let's see the applications. The sample and hold circuit is used in the pulse modulation system. It is used in the digital interface. It is also used for A to D conversion, that means analog to digital conversion. As we are applying input voltage as a sine voltage and output is nothing but sample and holding value, which also considered as signal to be sampled only at a specific period of time. Therefore, it can be used in the sample and hold circuit. The another application of sample and hold circuit, that it can be used in analog demultiplexer. So these are the certain applications of sample and hold circuit using op-amp. So basically the sample and hold circuit operation depends upon position of switch, that means whether switch is on or switch is off, and that is controlled by using a control voltage. The switch can be BJT or MOSFET, and the operation having two process, sampling process and holding process. Sampling is the process during which the output is get sampled, and holding is the process during which the capacitor hold the value for a certain period of time. So this is what about the sample and hold circuit using op-amp. So I hope you understand this topic of sample and hold circuit. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.